Make a call to order, the Tuesday, July 21, 2020, County Board Supervisors meeting. Are we certified in compliance with the open meeting law?
Yes, the agenda was posted on the 17th of July at 3:30 PM.
Okay, would you all please join me in the pledge of allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call.
All right. Voice vote for roll call here. Supervisor Smith.
Present.
Supervisor Gruber.
Here.
Supervisor Schneider.
Here.
Supervisor Montanior.
Here.
Supervisor Clark.
Here.
Supervisor Nelson.
Here.
Supervisor Procheck.
Present.
Supervisor Koch.
Here.
Supervisor Schobert. Supervisor Brower.
Here.
Supervisor Jorgensen.
Here.
Supervisor Zubelbauer.
Here.
Supervisor Nenning.
Here.
Supervisor Hopler. Supervisor Kulo.
Here.
Supervisor Dan. Supervisor Wagner.
Here.
Supervisor Himmel.
Here.
Supervisor OJ.
Here.
Supervisor Hoffman.
Here.
Supervisor Hilbling.
Here.
Supervisor Bosman.
Here.
Supervisor Beldman.
Here.
Supervisor Garing.
Here.
Supervisor Testrudy.
Here.
And we have Supervisor Schobert coming in the door right now. So we have 23 supervisors present.
Thank you. Consideration of memorial resolutions. Resolution number six.
board supervisor for 6 years from 2006 to 2012, on the Human Resources Committee from 2006 to 2012, serving as chairperson from 2008 to 2010, and on the Healthcare Center Committee from 2010 to 2012. And whereas Mr. Schultz also served his community as alderperson from 1990 to 2003, volunteering his time at Immaculate Conception Catholic Church, as well as other area parochial schools, the Stephanie Wild Center, the Sheboygan AARP program, and voting polls, and serving for 25 years as secretary and treasurer for Branch 13 of Catholic Financial Light, as well as being a member of the Knights of Columbus. And whereas Mr. Schultz will be remembered for his ability to pull together fellow supervisors with competing opinions to find common ground and consensus. Now therefore, let it be resolved that by passage of this resolution, the county board herewith makes public recognition of Mr. Schultz's dedicated service to the citizens of the county and expresses its heartfelt sympathy to the family and friends, and especially his wife Susie Schultz and his children, Valentine Bud Schultz Jr., Todd Schultz, and Brenda B. Warren. Be it further resolved that the clerk be directed to forward a copy of this resolution to his family, respectfully submitted this 21st day of July 2020.
Pursuant to County Board Rule 2.13, this resolution will be on the floor for immediate action. Please join me in a standing vote and a moment of silence. Thank you. Would Susie Schultz like to come up and receive a copy of the resolution? Thank you very much. Next is the approval of the June 16, 2020 journal. As the chair, I would like the minutes to show that we met remotely. So is there a motion to approve the minutes? Supervisor Immel?
I make the motion to approve.
Thank you, Supervisor Immel. Supervisor Hoffman?
I second that motion.
Thank you, Supervisor Immel. Under discussion, are there any changes? Okay, then we'll have a voice vote. All those in favor of the minutes from June 16, 2020, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Presentations?
We have none.
Public addresses?
There are none.
Okay. Letters, communications, and announcements?
I had a public.
In order to speak before the county board, you would need to register.
I did. I did yesterday.
You did not sign up to speak.
Yes, I did.
You had a list of questions that I answered, but I don't recall.
I can probably find it in my notes somewhere. That was, I think, my main thing was that I was going to speak. I just wanted to talk tonight a little bit about why I started getting involved in the county and the city things. It wasn't until this COVID was brought up, and I was very disappointed with the May meeting where everything seemed to be pushed through. It was pulled out of committee. same way I was, and we wanted to, you know, address that. Then came to today, tonight's meeting, and just by me getting a hold of John, that's how I found out it was moved to the Wombat Room. I would have gone down to the courthouse tonight, not knowing a thing happened. I think there could be a lot better communication between us and the people that are supposed to represent us. I, up to this point in time, have never been involved in any local politics, so didn't know where to even look for any of the information. John was very good about telling me how to find things on the internet, where to go to do any of this. And, you know, I appreciate that. But as far as, you know, the way we find things out, and then all of a sudden, it's going to be pulled out of a committee again and voted on. I just don't see the reason why, when I know that there are other counties who are opening up these meetings to their people, letting them know about it, their board members are telling them about the meetings, we're just kept in the dark here in Sheboygan County. And I just don't appreciate that. And there are quite a few that I believe I can talk for tonight who would say the same thing. It's been not a good situation for us. You know, we first had the lockdown, and now we feel locked out. And it's something we think needs to be changed. We have to be able to speak back and forth freely, be able to share our thoughts with all of you. And I don't think we've been given that recognition, and we're being disenfranchised by the board, not being able to speak our minds. So I would ask that we get some notification of the meetings. Tonight I was also told there would be no remote meetings, so we had to come out, which, you know, is fine, but we've got to know where it is. And also, sometimes it's done by remote, sometimes it isn't. I can't wait till that 24-hour agenda to find out what has been decided by a board who's had the agenda for 5 days already. So I would suggest you either post it in the Sheboygan Press or on their Facebook page or something so that we're notified and we have some say-so and some very important things that are happening to us in our community. So that's about it. Thank you.
Next is letters, communications, and announcements.
I have several resolutions. There are two resolutions from Dunn and Crawford County Boards of Supervisors regarding nonpartisan procedure for redistricting maps.
Okay, that has come before us and sent to committee in the past, so this time we'll receive it for information.
Next, I have a resolution from Juneau County Board of Supervisors requesting the State Senate reconvene to address 13 water bills passed by the Assembly.
That has also come before us in the past, so we'll receive it for information.
Finally, I have two resolutions, one from Washera County, the other from Winnebago County Boards of Supervisors supporting the Commitment to Veterans Support and Outreach Act.
That has also come before us in the past, so we'll receive it this time for information.
That is all I have.
On the administrator's report.
Hey, Mr. Chairman, good evening.
Good evening.
The somber way to start a meeting when you look around the room and, you know, of course, we're all wearing masks to protect one another and offer some protection to ourselves. And we have two resolutions recognizing two dearly departed public servants who really did a lot for this community. Alex Hopkins, 40 years, and imagine working 40 years at Corporation Council. I'm sure Crystal is going to try to beat that record. I just can't imagine the challenges that Alex and all of those county boards and staff over the years must have been presented with and how they worked together in collaboration to do the best they could for the community. I started in 99 and 2000, so I didn't work with Alex, but I did have the opportunity to meet with him on a few occasions, and he just always seemed like such a thoughtful, mindful person. And I thought Crystal did a real nice job succinctly capturing what an incredible person Bell's never on the executive committee, finance committee, so I didn't get to know him like I certainly get to know our executive and finance committee members, but I got to know him well enough to appreciate again what a class act he was. Person of integrity, and he was always looking to do a problem solve and bring people together. And that's personally what I've really enjoyed about working with this county board for the last 22 years is there's just so many good people on this board that served in the past and that are serving today. You're not here for the money. You're not here for the masks. You're here because you want to do the right thing for this community and keep it safe and continue to make it better. So I appreciate these two dearly departed souls' public service, and I certainly appreciate yours. I was thinking about Bill Jens and Don Tram and Bill Seibold and Connie Zimmerbauer and Howard Belhorst and Bud Peterson and Jack Van Dixhorn a little bit today and thinking, wow, what they would have thought to see this day. How many of us have watched the news in the past and you see, I don't know if it was China or Japan or both, that had masks on because of the air pollution? We've seen that in the past, right? I can recall years ago seeing that on the news and thinking, thank goodness, that's not in the United States of America. Thank goodness we've taken steps with environmental protections that we're not wearing those masks. I hope that never comes to be. But of course, now we're wearing them because we have a health pandemic, because people are dying, because families are being negatively impacted, and because we care about one another. Care about our community. So it was just a few months ago that this hit us, right? Talk about uncertain times. It is a week-by-week decision where we're going to meet and whether it's going to be teleconference and if we can have adequate social distancing and who can be here and who can't be. I mean, times are uncertain. This is how it is. No, nobody wants this uncertainty. This is how it is. And in March, when you had a county board meeting, I don't know if that was the first one at the theater or not, I don't recall anymore, but on March 17th, we had 4 positive cases in Sheboygan County. 4, 0 deaths. Wisconsin had 72 positive cases, no deaths. The United States had 7,038 positive cases, 260 deaths. We're just starting to hear about this coronavirus, at least in the state of Wisconsin. Globally, they were hearing about it, certainly. But for the state of Wisconsin, you know, that's not Wisconsin, right? That's not going to come to the Midwest. In April, we had 48 positive cases and 2 deaths in Sheboygan County. It was starting to become a little more real. And our nursing homes, like Sunny Ridge, certainly felt the impact of that, as did our hospitals and other healthcare providers and emergency responders who got engaged. Wisconsin had 6,289 positive cases, 300 deaths. And the United States had 981, 246 positive cases, 60,000 deaths in April. April 28th. Fast forward to today, July 21st. Sheboygan County has 423 positive cases. Again, these are the cases we know of, right? Fortunately, only 5 deaths. Maybe only isn't the right word, but we sure are grateful it's not more than that. Wisconsin has 44,135 positive cases, 859 deaths in the state of Wisconsin. And across the United States, we have 3.9 million positive cases with 143,000 deaths since March. Times are uncertain. As I think we've all shared with one another before, how proud are we of our public health professionals? Our public health staff have just been outstanding. And the guidelines that we prepared, the collaboration at the state level and federal level, really have made a difference. In fact, we're holding our own quite some of us in this room maybe don't want to put a mask on. Every single day, they go to work and they put on a heavy-duty mask, and gloves, and gowns, and all sorts of PPEs to make sure that they're protecting their residents. Your family members, my family members, our neighbors, our friends, every day they do that. See the sores that get around where they wear the masks all day long? The trepidation they feel, will I get COVID? Will I take it home to my family? Our public direct health care providers, our private health care direct care providers have been fantastic. And Rocky Knoll just had a survey, a state survey, a couple of weeks ago, specifically looking at our COVID plans and preparations. We knocked it out of the park. And knocked on wood, we continue to be one of the nursing homes in the county that hasn't had positive COVID cases amongst our residents. Sadly, that can happen to anyone at any time, and it has happened in other nursing homes in our community, and certainly across the state and country, as you know. So pleased with that feedback, and also so grateful for the leadership of our business community. Wow. Aditra Martinez with the Chamber, and Joe Sheehan with the Sheboygan County Economic Development Corporation. They've been working with the state, again, the state guidelines, Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation. Been working with a lot of our business leaders. Public health has been having routine meetings with business leaders. And as you are all hearing, more and more businesses, more and more companies are requiring their staff to wear masks, requiring the public that comes into their business to wear masks. Why? Because they're paying attention to the data and what's happening across the country, and they want to protect their employees, and they want to protect this community. And certainly health is number one. I would hope we would all agree to that. But if we don't take these steps and more people get sick and they can't go to work, how do you keep the doors open in your business? We also have a lot of people that don't want to go into businesses if they haven't seen precautions taken to keep people safe. So I am so grateful for the leadership of our business community. A lot of people are stepping up, and we're seeing more and more of that going on. And we need to celebrate that and express our appreciation. In the daily updates from public health, they provide a lot of information, actually. But I put on your desk this evening, or as you came in this evening, there's a document on mass gatherings. And I encourage you to take a look at this when you get a chance. The county board went on record supporting our public health staff and supporting the guidelines that we provide, right? You support public health, you support the guidelines, and I certainly do as well because I work for you. And part of those guidelines discourage mass gatherings for obvious reasons. And what's the perfect number? I mean, this is not a perfect science with 6 feet versus 8 or 10, and should it be 25 people or 50 people? But based on local, state, and federal public health professional input, that's how these guidelines were established. So real pleased that recently we've seen some communities take some very responsible actions to limit the amount of mass gatherings. Very important. Very important. And all of us need to lead by example in that regard. I mean, in this room today, we have over 25 people, right? But we are essential because you're government. And when you're essential, just like if you're processing food at Johnsonville or Master Gallery or Sargento, there are exceptions for essential workforces or people. Government is essential. So we still do the best we can to keep everybody safe, which is why we're here. Why we're social distancing, which is why we're respectfully asking everyone to put a mask on
1:35.
1:35. I mean, we're all looking forward to that. We have so many staff involved with helping prepare for that, transportation, law enforcement, health, and human services. There's some meetings going on for the last year and a half. We just built a new facility at the airport. We'll be cutting the ribbon for the US Customs facility in the next month or two, with a very small gathering. But the Ryder Cup officials, ultimately, they were thinking, well, if we're going to hold this, it probably won't be with fans, because of public safety. And if there's no fans, there's no economic impact. So I think most people ultimately close to it, involved with it, were very pleased that it was postponed for a year. The Kohler Company released a statement immediately following the decision to postpone the tournament, saying, "It is in the support of the choice to reschedule. It is in support of the choice to reschedule, as the health and well-being of everyone involved is a top priority." The PGA CEO, Seth Wu, said, "As disappointed as this is, our mandate is to do all we can to safeguard public health, because that's what matters most." Grateful for that leadership. Our guidelines don't require anybody to do anything. So people and businesses need to take responsibility. Everybody says, "Allow us to take our own individual responsibility." Then do it. And fortunately, a lot of people are, and we're very thankful for that. The final thing is, you have an ordinance before you, and the reason this is being pulled, for the benefit of some of the folks who maybe don't normally attend a county board meeting, is normally it always goes to a committee, to the board, and back to a committee. And for two board meetings, we, the county board, supported an emergency declaration that authorized the county to expend resources, as you all know, for COVID-related expenses. Personal protective equipment, staff, contract tracers, things like that. It allowed up to $500,000 over the course of those two emergency declarations to be expended by yours truly. And of course, that's done in collaboration with our public health team and the executive committee and others. We spent a total of $400,000 to date on personal protective equipment, contract tracers, additional staff for health and human services, Rocky Knoll adjustments such as that. All very prudent, all directly associated with COVID. And I'm hopeful most, if not all of it, will be reimbursed through the state and federal government. We're actively pursuing that. We have about $150 million budget in the county. 19 departments from A to Z, law enforcement, health and human services, planning, conservation, you name it. And when the board takes action and supports that budget, the department heads, and yours truly, are responsible to administer, work within that budget, and provide those funds, allocate those resources as needed to address things, whether it's mental health, child abuse, you name it. Here, in this ordinance, we're asking for the county board's support in three areas tonight. And the reason it is being pulled is because that second emergency declaration ends today. Rather than using that state declaration of emergency language, which created some angst, we all know that in this room, it created some angst, we sought to avoid that and not repeat that. Instead, this would be an ordinance that will do three things. It authorizes the county board chair to convene off-site or virtual county board meetings as needed. What's been happening now. We anticipate this will continue to happen through the rest of this term. Hopefully, we'll be back in the county board chamber sooner rather than later. We all want that. But it gives the county board chair discretion to authorize and convene off-site or virtual county board meetings. It allows liaison committees to also meet remotely. So if someone's not feeling well, they can call in. Makes a lot of sense in light of what we're dealing with. And then finally, it authorizes the county administrator to continue to make COVID-19 expenditures as needed, if needed. Hope we don't have to spend another penny on COVID. But I think we all know in this room, that's probably not going to be the case. We're probably going to need more personal protective equipment. We may need more contact tracers. And in instances when things surge, we need to be nimble and respond quickly. We don't go back to the county board if there's a roof leak. We don't go back to the county board if a boiler breaks down, or the heating unit breaks down, there is some authorization for us to respond to a need, a crisis, if there's no heat in the building in the winter, right? This is a crisis, this would authorize us to continue to purchase personal protective equipment and other things as needed, if needed, but we've added with the overview and approval of the executive committee, make sure we have a little bit more oversight from policymakers, which is great, which is just fine. So there you have, that's what's before you this evening. It's here because that declaration is ending, and I want to thank everybody for your time and certainly your support. This is such a challenging time for all of us. I know that many of you are getting calls and emails like I am and from all spectrums, and it's difficult. And some people have lost patience and kindness. Some people aren't as mindful as they could be. And none of us asked for this. Yet here we are. And we're going to do the best we can. And we're going to err on the side of caution in protecting this community's health. And we're going to work in collaboration, just as we have always done. We're going to get through this. We're talking about vaccines that are going to start rolling out hopefully late this year. I certainly hope you see mass distribution of them next. And hopefully come July, August of next summer, we're back in the county board chambers. And the masks are nowhere to be seen. Right? And we're back to somewhat of the new norm. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Next is consideration of committee reports. Resolution number four.
Regarding authorizing agreement for use of ring of fiber infrastructure by Board of Regents of the University of Wisconsin system for University of Wisconsin Green Bay Sheboygan campus. Committee recommendation to adopt.
Supervisor Wagner?
I'll move for passage of resolution number four.
Thank you, Supervisor Wagner. Supervisor Gehring?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would second that motion.
Thank you, Supervisor Gehring. Under discussion? With no discussion, we'll have a voice vote. All those in favor, resolution number four, signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carried. Resolution number five.
Regarding authorizing entering into a memorandum of understanding with the Aurora Healthcare Central, Inc. for the provision of healthcare services to the uninsured and underinsured residents of Sheboygan County. Committee recommendation adopt.
Supervisor Hoffman.
Mr. Chair, I recommend that we approve resolution number five.
Thank you, Supervisor Hoffman. Supervisor Immel.
I second that motion, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Supervisor Immel. Under discussion? Okay, then we'll have a voice vote. All those in favor of resolution number five signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Consideration of committee reports. Committee report.
Regarding the Joint County Library Service Plan from 2021 through 2025, committee recommendation to concur with the report.
Supervisor Gehring.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move to concur with the report.
Thank you, Supervisor Gehring. Supervisor Nelson.
Thank you, Chairman Koch. I second that motion.
Thank you, Supervisor Nelson. Under discussion. Seeing no hands, all those in favor of concurring with the Joint County Library Service Plan signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carried.
Good evening to all. Resolutions introduced. Resolution number eight.
From the Finance Committee regarding approving standard intergovernmental agreement for 2021 county sales tax revenue sharing.
Resolution number eight will be referred to Executive Committee. Resolution number nine.
From Transportation Committee regarding authorizing sale of sliver of county property at County Road EE and South 12th Street.
That will also be referred to Executive Committee. Ordinance is introduced. Ordinance number two.
From the Executive Committee regarding
motion to pull, I don't want to talk about the motion.
This is a non-debatable motion.
Okay, thank you.
We're set. Supervisor Smith?
Yes.
Supervisor Gruber?
Yes.
Supervisor Schneider?
Yes.
Supervisor Montemayor?
Yes.
Supervisor Clark?
Yes.
Supervisor Nelson?
No.
Supervisor Procha?
Yes.
Supervisor Koch?
Yes.
Supervisor Schobert?
Yes.
Supervisor Brower?
Yes.
Supervisor Jorgensen?
Yes.
Supervisor Riegelbauer?
Yes.
Supervisor Nenick?
Yes.
Supervisor Pulo?
Yes.
Supervisor Wagner?
Yes.
Supervisor Kimmel?
Yes.
Supervisor OJ?
No.
Supervisor Hoffman?
Yes.
Supervisor Hilbling?
Yes.
Supervisor Bosman?
Yes.
Supervisor Belton?
Yes.
Supervisor Garing?
Yes.
Supervisor Testrudy?
Yes.
Yeah, motion to pull is passed.
Plan accomplished?
21-2.
And now we'll need a motion for ordinance number two. Supervisor Quaker?
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chair. Gotta straighten out my mask. I'll move for approval of ordinance number two.
Supervisor Hoffman?
I concur with that.
Thank you. Now it's open for debate, discussion. Supervisor Nelson?
Well, I just wanted to comment on pulling the motion. Pulling is, or was at one time not very often happened and only in certain circumstances. As you recall, I think it was two meetings ago, I voted against pulling another motion. I am going to vote for it. It's very important to have it, but just I don't feel that I don't want pulling motions to get to be common. I'd rather have them stay rare. I'm not sure that wait another month to pass this. So, as I say, that's why I voted against pulling the motion, but I will be voting for it because, of course, it's a very important motion.
Thank you, Supervisor Nelson. Is there any other discussion? Supervisor Roque.
Mr. Vice Chairman, I figure I might as well speak since I voted against it, too. I guess my issue here is this didn't all of a sudden sneak up on us in the last 30 days. This could have been addressed. It could have gone to committee because that's where the what-ifs happen. And, well, is this really the best way to go about this? And we didn't do any of that. And now here we sit, and if I want to change anything, I have to try to convince people in this room to change something. And quite honestly, I don't have the energy to keep doing that every time we pull something. But my issues with this are I don't have a problem with people being allowed to attend a meeting remotely. I think it's a smart thing to do if people are uncomfortable. But I think you also have to have that meeting in a public location so the public can be there. And for those of us who absolutely despise remote meetings, can actually be somewhere to attend it. Because personally, even with a mask, it's hard for me to understand people or hear people. I spent 25 years in a foundry. Remote meetings don't work well for me at all. I can't hear, so I end up with issues with that. So I think if this would have gone to committee, maybe there would have been something done so that there would be still public access to a meeting, a location where people could go, where whether it's set up on a screen and members who want to go there are there at the meeting. To me, that's important, as you've heard from a member of the public. Public meetings should be public, not me sitting in my living room and you sitting in your kitchen. That's not really a public meeting. You don't get the feel for it or anything else about what's going on. strong way, Adam, but both of us could drop over dead tomorrow, so I can't say, well, I trust Adam as the county administrator. This ordinance doesn't just give the county administrator the ability to expend funds with the vote of three members of the executive committee. It gives them the ability to completely alter our budget and what committee or what department had what money, because this clearly says reallocate in here. I want to say in that, if something's going to be pulled from the committee that I oversee or from some other committee I feel unfortunately about, I want to have a say in that. This doesn't give that to me. This ordinance clearly says I have to rely on the executive committee to do what hopefully is right for the people I represent. That's also not me serving the public. So that's why I'm going to vote against this. Not because there aren't good things in here, but I think there's things in here that need to be fixed.
Motion has been made in the second to adjourn.